I'm going to start with this ergonomic analysis based on simulation. So I've uploaded a video without sound. However, I will run it and I'll show you what we can run over here. If we go to the ergonomics manual, there maybe we can find some of the procedures which so we can see over here a computer aided ergonomics experiment 5 is there. So in this case, this is evaluation of manual lifting task using NIOSH lifting equation and its comparison based on HCAD. HCAD is a software which the department has purchased and it's available on one of the computers of the lab. So in this HCAD, we can have a mannequin of the specific anthropometric dimensions or the dimensions relative to any country or related to any region. Or you can change the dimension according to the anthropometric dimensions available for a specific design. That is your choice. So what we can do, there are three basic options which are possible in here. One is three-dimensional modeling of the workplace and equipment. Third is three-dimensional modeling to represent various anthropometric postures. Then evaluation technique to assess reach, vision, fit, posture. Whether the human is fitting to a particular posture or not, that we can evaluate. So there are three basic objectives. One is what we do is first is okay. So the first point is we can perform NIOSH lifting equation analysis. Second is we can design a workspace and we can place a mannequin and we can analyze reach, vision, etc. So we can apply vision, etc. How much the person can see, how much it is possible. Third is what is possible in here is loading in terms of torque at different body joints. So these are three basic objectives which we can do in this this analysis where we are using human CAD. So human CAD is next gen company's software for human simulation and ergonomic analysis. We will see here what other things we can do in this part. So this is the main objectives, three objectives which we can try to achieve using the HCAD. So this is a software available. 15 days trial is already available on online. If you want to use, you can use it. Now, if I run this video, in this video, we can see this is an HCAD which had been started. So see here, this is how, these are some windows like home, views, design, and Argo tools. Okay, so these are some of the factors. These are Argo tools. Wait, Argo tools means you can perform NIOSH analysis. NIOSH analysis, you can perform torque and you can see different joint movements. These are three basic tools available in this model. And when we go to design, we can see that home, there are many options for saving. For this, you can see here. In this case, in design, you can see if you want to import a mannequin, this is an option. If you want to see the different joints of mannequins, you have an option over here. If you want to make a rotation, shift, movements. All these possibilities are over here in operation section. Then you can have 2D polynomials. If you want to draw some shapes, either planes or solid bodies, these are some of the limited drawing options. But there are options available in this HCAD. If you have an AutoCAD or SolidWorks on model, you can import in this software. And that model could be your workspace. And that workspace, we can place mannequin and we can analyze how much is the region of sections, how much is the reach, what is the envelope of hand, what is the envelope of feet. So all these things could be analyzed ergonomically. Let's see here how it goes. First of all, we see here if we have to build an object over here, how we can make a geometry in this 3D space. This is the way of making the geometry. We are taking a solid body option over here, and later on using these operations you can tilt it, place it, etc. in a particular we can say a particular direction. We can transform the object over here. Now further, what we see here, these are the move options. There are rotation options available here in operations section. If we have to change the view, either 3D to 2D views, we will go to what is a view option over here. Now this is a window where many items, whatever have been imported in that particular file. Now you see here, I just pause it for a moment. This is an option for importing mannequin into the workspace. When you import mannequin, there is an option for a standard or advanced. The type of posture, type of hand posture, certain limitations are there with the software. Male, female, Indian anthropometry, or any other country's anthropometry. Which percentile value you want? 90 percentile, 50 percentile, 5 percentile, 95th percentile. Height and weight if you want to adjust further. Advanced options if you want to see. So there, or skeletal you want to see instead of the solid body. So these are many options available in here, which we see how the selection of the mannequins is required for your ergonomic analysis that can be put in here. First of all, we take torque body joint option. So if we take torque body joint option, then we are importing a mannequin. Let's see here. This is a mannequin, a particular posture we had selected, but we can change the posture by selecting the joint options. There are many options. You can rotate, you can select different body parts, you can rotate into different directions, and then you can see the changes which are coming over here. There are different parts of the body and the anthropometry, mannequin. So whatever items are there, this is a 3D space, directions which are guiding us to rotate in a particular way. So these are green points which are body joints available with this. If you want to change the hand with respect to elbow, we can rotate it like this, or we can change the views. There are different views, 3D views, left end view, right end view, top views. Like that you can change, or you can rotate it by using this rotate option, or by zoom in or zoom out options. When you go to design options, you can apply certain load. For example, the person is holding a weight of 100 newtons. So in negative direction, so on his hand, there is a force acting in negative direction. If force is acting in negative direction on hand, on the left hand, how the torques are available in different body joints of the mannequin. If we select the mannequin, we see that what are the jobs options over here. So this is what we see here, different torque options. Let's take torque at left wrist is maximum because load is basically applied over here. So load is applied over here. So maximum torque is on the wrist joint. Then on the elbow, you see on the hip because of the body weight, etc., left hip. So if you change the posture, you can see how the torques on the different body joints are changed. And accordingly, you can redesign the work, design the task, redesign the work space. There are many options available for different body postures. You can transform the one body posture to the other body posture, and then you can see. Now, if I am placing the load on the second hand also, on the right hand, 100 newtons, same we are applying here in the negative direction. Now, both the hands are loaded with 100 newtons. Let's see how we go to ergonomics tools. We go to torque option. First, just zooming in. Go to ergonomics tool, go to torque options, and when you go to torque options, you can see the torque has been slightly changed. So we have updated this. We will update graph, we will select mannequin, and we can see if now in this case we are seeing that our right wrist is not loaded. It means we have not placed the load at a right location. So load may be away from the wrist. The selection was not proper. That's why the loading is not visible in here. Now take another mannequin, the standing posture, import it, create another mannequin just for the comparison of torques. In a standing, if we put a load on second mannequin, selection of second mannequin is there. We apply a load of 100 newtons down there. Then we can see how this is for rotation about the body joints. So there you can zoom out, zoom in. Fine. See here, selected mannequins. You can shift it if you want to shift. This is design. You want to shift from one location to other. This mannequin can be shifted. Downward direction, unfortunately, we can shift it. We can undo this option. Then we can rotate it and see how the posture is different. So we have undone the operation. We can see if we want to shift it, we can take the directions, rotations, movement, and now according to x-axis we can shift it. So guides are very helpful. These guides are very helpful for making a shift, making a rotation, so that it would be very proper. Now apply the load on left hand, again 100 newtons. Let's take taking 100 newtons, we can again go to the analysis tool. This is view option. We can see, go to the Argo tools, go to the torque evaluation for mannequin 0, for mannequin 2. You see here, there is a change over here. So with respect to both the postures, we can compare both the figures. You can import these figures or you can cut and paste these figures, and you can compare the torque at different body joints for one posture with the other posture. So posture effect on joint loading could be analyzed using here. So these are the numerical values which were represented in terms of graphs over there. Second part in this is NIOSH lifting analysis. As we all know, you have done in the previous semester that NIOSH lifting equation helps you to find out the optimum load to be lifted. So this NIOSH lifting index or lifting equation is used for finding out. So using this software, we can we can choose origin posture and destination posture, nation posture, and then we can see how the load can be optimized and lifting index could be calculated. Lifting index can be calculated, optimum load can be, maximum allowable load can be calculated. See here how it goes in this software. Select again a mannequin posture, just taking a sitting posture to the standing posture. So for Niosh lifting, we are taking these two postures, which are very similar, just two posture and the standing posture. So one mannequin is created. Let's see here. This is in a stoop posture. Another mannequin we will create with the same geometry, just for the standing posture, slightly hands above the shoulder. So this will be our two postures where we can see for the destination and for the origin. So anyone can be destination or origin. So this way we are just having at the same location. We are not giving any asymmetry, which is also a factor in Niosh lifting equation about the horizontal axis, whether the trunk is rotated or not. So we are not giving any asymmetry, but we can give it in here if we wish. So go to the Niosh lifting equation. You can select mannequin one away, first mannequin and the second mannequin here. You can update the values, which are the basic parameters: horizontal distance, vertical distance, asymmetry, frequency of lift, duration of hours per day, and the weight which the person is being lifting, and the coupling. So these are the parameters which we already know about calculating the Niosh lifting index. So these parameters help us to find out the optimum weight. Once we apply these values, we can go to this calculate option. Coupling for frequency of lift, let's have 1. Then duration of hours, let's have 4 hours. Weight can be 20 kg or something like that. Then go to the fair quality of coupling. We can see the values over here. These are two lifting index, these are two weights. So this origin, you have selected the 0 mannequin, destination you have selected the first mannequin. It can be either way around. From top to bottom, there may be a load placing task along the gravity or against the gravity. So in both the cases, we have calculated. Once I have changed the horizontal distance, and we see that the allowable load is increased. So that is what the second part of the HCAD analysis. Third part is analyzing vision, work analysis, reach, and obstructions in the in what we call a work space. So if we have created a mannequin again, just a sitting posture, you can have an object place in front of the subject, draw that object, make a geometry, and that geometry can be that body can be rotated accordingly so that it can be properly placed in front of the person. We can have this object according to guides. We can change the shape and we can place it in front of the person. It is down. Now we will see that how much it is obstructing the person's reach. So this is what we are using the analysis. So if we go to this side, scene 3. So here in scene 3, what we see is we have many options over here. left hand reach volume. This is an envelope in which the person is working. Left foot on the floor, put the foot on the floor. If it is not on the floor, you can apply this option. But now, there may be n number of mannequins in the workspace. So you can select mannequin one and you can have many options over here. See what is the feet volume for the left feet, the area for the right foot or hand. So if you change the posture, the volume will change. If you change the flexion and extension of the neck, vision will change. Let's see here how we can ergonomically analyze any workspace imported into HCAD along with the particular size anthropometric size of a mannequin. So this is possible over here. Show left foot reach. So left foot can be rotate in this way. Right foot reach. So these are the volumes. If you rotate this workspace, you can see that how the volume is covering the envelope around the mannequin. So this is a vision what person is able to see in front of it. This is sometimes very important in case of analyzing the design of an automobile, in car, in front screen, windscreen, side screen. So the person's vision is properly analyzed. So if I change the flexion of the neck, the vision angle, vision area, vision volume will change accordingly. And again, you can see that what is available in his vision. So these are many options. You see many options over here. Put the right foot on the floor. Show the right foot reach volume, left foot reach volume, right hand reach volume, left hand reach volume. So the eye view from the left eye, from the right eye, maximum vision volume. This is maximum vision volume we see over here. Then we see optimum vision volume, which is this cone. Then for example, person is doing hammering, person is doing a fitting operation, person is working on an assembly. It depends upon how much requirement is. So the same assembly, if you are not able to design in this HCAD, you can design in AutoCAD or you can design in NXCAD and you can import that file. That will be available as a workstation. You can import the mannequin, you can fit the mannequin, and you can further analyze how much obstructions are there in that particular vision area. So this is what HCAD is about. We see here, so HCAD is used for three particular analysis. One is if you have some loading in hand, the person is lifting a weight or transporting something, some object, or the posture loading on the different body joints. So the torques, which are the reaction torques on the body joints, can be evaluated, assessed. So this is a simulation, a specific purpose simulation software. Now in this case, second is you can analyze the vision, you can analyze the reach, you can analyze the volume, how much the person is able to see, how much the space person can adjust within the space. For example, underneath car, the person is working, so you can have the volume and you can see that. So in this is what it is. Second is, third is, you can perform the NIOSH lifting analysis. So you can do the lifting index as well here. So that is possible. You can do the lifting index. So these three analyses are possible using the HCAD. All right. So this was all about HCAD. There is another experiment